Hello students, this is the third part of the lesson. We are continuing the lesson and this is the last part of the lesson. Okay, in the last part we have learned the letter that Jim McPherson has written to Connie McPherson, and we read the whole lesson, the whole letter. It was an event that happened at the battleground. Okay, now we are going to third part and I start reading. I folded the letter again and slipped it carefully back into its envelope. Now remember, it is the author who is talking here. Okay, he folded the letter and put back in the envelope. I kept awake all night because the whole night he was thinking how he is going to find out this lady and how he is going to return this letter to her. By morning, I knew what I had to do. So he made a plan and he knew what he had to do. I drove into Bridport. Bridport is the city. Just a few miles away, I asked a boy walking his dog where Copper Beaches was. So Copper Beaches is the name of the street. So he asked one boy, where is this address? House number 12. Turned out to be nothing but a burned house cell. So when he went there, on this address the house was actually burnt, completely destroyed by fire. Burnt out, it means completely destroyed by fire. The roof was open, the windows boarded up, the windows were also covered with wooden boards. I knocked at the house next door and I asked if anyone knew the whereabout of a Mrs. McPherson. So he went to ask the neighbor, where is Mrs. McPherson? Okay. Oh yes, said the old man in his slipper. He knew her well, a lovely lady, he told me, a bit muddle-headed. Muddle means a bit confused, but at her age she was entitled to be, because she was very old, so she's okay to be confused. Okay. Wasn't she 101 year old? Remember that Connie McPherson was now 101 years old. That is why she was a bit confused. Another thing is that she was also waiting for her husband to join her. That is why she was confused. She had been in the house when it caught the fire. No one really knew how the fire had started, but it could well have been candle. It means it is possible that the house was caught because of candle. She was not using electricity much. She used to use candle. Okay. So, and because of candle, the fire caught the whole house. She used candle rather than electricity because she always thought electricity was too expensive. Some people are like that. Okay. The fireman had got her out just in time. It means she was about to die, but the fireman brought her outside just in time. She was in a nursing home now. But she always thought the electricity was too expensive. The fireman had got her just in time. She was in a nursing home now, he told me. Wellington House on the Dorsetshire Road, on the other side of the town. So the man gave him another address where there is a nursing house where Connie McPherson is staying now. Okay, next page. I found Burlington House nursing home easily enough. It was quite easy to find it because it is in the same town. There were paper chains up in the hallway and lighted Christmas tree stood in the corner with the loop-sided angel on the top. It means the whole building was, inside the ceiling was decorated with the paper chain, and also there were Christmas trees standing in the corner, and on the Christmas tree there was a loop-sided angel on the top. I said I was a friend come to visit Mrs. McPherson to bring her a Christmas present. So it was a nursing home, so there is a reception where he has to ask permission to meet Connie McPherson, and he told there that he is a friend of Connie and he has brought a Christmas present to her. I could see through into the dining room where everyone was wearing a paper hat and singing. Everybody was wearing paper hat and singing the song because they are celebrating Christmas. The matron had a hat on too and seemed happy enough to see me. She was very happy to see me. See who? See the author. She even offered me a mince pie, which is in the triangle. It has a meat inside. Okay, so she offered him meat pie. She walked me along the corridor. Mrs. McPherson is not in with the others. She doesn't normally come with the others to celebrate Christmas, she told me. She is rather confused today, so we thought it is best if she had a good rest. So we thought that she should stay inside the room and take good rest. She has no family, you know. No one visit her. So I'm sure she will be only too pleased to see you. She will be very happy to see you. Okay. She took me in the conservatory with the wicker chair and potted plants all around and left me. You can see a wicker chair where she is sitting here and also plants around her. Okay. The old lady was sitting in a wheelchair, her hand folded in her lap. Her hands were folded on lap. Lap means on the leg. Okay. She had silver white hair pin into wispy bun. Wispy bun, it means, the meaning is given here. Wispy bun is a kind of hair that you make. You can see how she has tied her hair. That is called wispy bun. She was gazing out at the garden. Hello, I said. She turned and looked up at me vacantly. Vacantly means with empty mind. Happy Christmas, Connie, I went on. I found this. I think it's yours. So he is talking to Connie that he found this letter and I think it is yours. As I was speaking, her eyes never left my face. It means she was staring at me. I opened the tin box and gave it to her. That was the moment her eye lit up with recognition and her face became suffused with a sudden glow of happiness. She became very, very happy because she found what she always wanted. I explained about the desk, about how I had found it. But I don't think she was listening. She was not listening. She was just looking at him because she thought that it is her husband who has come to visit her on Christmas Day. For a while, and she said nothing, but stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. It means she folded the letter with the fingertips. Suddenly, she reached out and took my hand. So she held the author's hand. Her eyes were filled with the tears. She was crying. You told me you would come home by Christmas. And she told him that you promised me to come on the Christmas. Because she thought that it is her husband who has come. So out of emotion, she has started speaking. And she is crying actually. You told me that you would come home by Christmas, dearest, she said. And here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim dear, and sit down. I sat down beside her. See, the author also did not say anything because he didn't want to hurt somebody's feeling. So he just sat down there and kissed. I sat beside her and she kissed my cheek. I read your letter so often, Jim. Every day. She was reading that letter every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. She was eager to hear his voice. It always made me feel you were with me. And now you are here. Now you are back. You can read it to me yourself. She requested him to read the letter. Would you do that for me, Jim dear? I just want to hear your voice again. I would love that so much. And then perhaps we will have some tea. I have made you a nice Christmas cake. Marzipan all around. I know how much you love marzipan. And she just thought, she was a bit confused because she has not seen her husband for so many years. So she thought that it is her husband who has come. And she was just treating Michael, the author, as her husband. And that was the best Christmas present for her. Not the letter. Of course the letter was, but she, the person who has come, she thought that it is her husband. And that was the best Christmas present. And that is why she was being so nice to him, making him sit down, kissed on his cheek, and she told him to read the letter because she want to hear her voice. And she also said that I will prepare tea for you to drink. I will prepare Christmas cake, the marzipan that you really like. I will prepare it for you and we will enjoy here. So this is the end of the lesson. Quite sad because the main person, Mr. MacPherson, he died at the war. He never came. But Mrs. MacPherson, she was eagerly waiting for the husband. Finally, he got the letter, not the husband, but at least she is okay to receive the author. And the author was also quite sad. Okay. So this is the lesson. I'm sure you have understood the lesson. If you have any question, you can send me the message. I will try to give answer of all your questions. Thank you so much.